What's going on, guys? This is Riggs from Clashing FFS, bringing you yet another brand new video. And what we're going to be talking about today is attack strategies at Town Hall 10. And I know it's something that a lot of people have been asking for on the channel. We do a lot of attack strategies, but in this one, we're actually going to be breaking down exactly what is going on behind the attacks. The very first attack strategy that we're going to be featuring on the channel, and it's something we're going to be doing in the near future as well, posting different attack strategies. So what we're going to be showing you guys on this one, or in this video, is the bitch attack, aka Bowitch, whatever you're allowed to say. But yeah, so we're going to be covering the Bowitch attack. There's a lot of different ways of doing this attack, and we're going to see a few different variations in this video. We do have a total of 4 replays and different things that you can bring in the clan castle, where that's going to be a max golem, where that's going to be max bowlers coming out of the CC. We've even seen examples of bringing giants now on these attacks. So there's a lot of different variations that we are seeing. So it's definitely something that we want to cover, especially post-update. And of course, it's all about base identification and what you are looking for. So the very first thing that we're going to be checking out right here is how Zongo is going to be breaking down this attack. So what he is doing, or the idea behind this, is he's going to be sending in his queen over here. He does have 4 healers. The thing that he wants to do with his queen is carve out all this stuff, right? He wants his queen to go ahead and take out all this crap. So that's what the queen's in charge of. Now, over or up at the top of the base, he's going to be dropping down 3 witches and a few bowlers. And again, the idea behind this is they're supposed to take out all the stuff that something like the witches can reach over the wall. Like so. So what does that leave? That leaves the kill squad, meaning, or the main push. The 2 golems, the rest of the bowlers. He does have CC bowlers on this one. And what their objective is they're supposed to push through this base. Now, the bowlers can reach everything over these walls. They can even reach this Inferno Tower, where he does have 2 jump, 2 rage, 1 heal. And you can pretty much see when he jumps into this base, you'll see right here, when he goes ahead and jumps into this base, we'll go ahead and we'll minus a few of these. So you'll see he's going to drop down a jump spell right there, and he's going to drop down a jump spell right there for his kill squad, 2 rages and the heal. And again, the reason why this attack strategy, it's always kind of been there, kind of, but it was a lot more base specific pre-update. But now, as you guys see, this attack is becoming much more prevalent in the new meta. So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and watch exactly how Zongo is going to do this. And over here on the upper left-hand side, you'll see he is dropping down archers just to trim this trash in order to keep the witches and the bowlers in the flank hugged up close to the wall, so they don't peel off and go all sorts of crazy where your witches and your bowlers start splitting. You want them to stay nice and tight. There you go. You see queen down. Clearly, she's going to be walking down. And you see the rest of the bowlers and the golems. Notice once he drops down that jump spell, he goes ahead and drops down king, along with his CC bowlers and that max giant paired up with them. There goes the jump spell right there in the core, leading to both of the Inferno Towers. Did have a poison spell as he dropped down that heal and his second rage for this main push. There was a golem loon that came out of the CC, and these bowlers pretty much one shot something like a defensive golem. Coming out of the CC, pretty much one shot, especially with that range that the bowlers have. And you'll see this base pretty much getting leveled. You can see his flank up here at the top doing very, very well. Did lose all of his bowlers, but those witches producing those skeletons, plus having that range, they can still do a lot of work, even if the bowlers do die off earlier on in the raid. The healers did peel off of the queen. But the key to this attack, guys, if you guys don't know it by now, The key to this attack is saving that Archer Queen ability till the very, very end. You'll see he does still have a full health, or pretty much a half health golem, while the Wizard Tower and the Tesla were being tanked by the golem. He went ahead and dropped down two hogs, just for good measure. And you'll see that is going to clearly wrap up the three-star for Zongo on number 18, Cured. Now I'll go ahead and check out another variation using this attack strategy. All right, guys, here is our very next example using the Bow Witch attack. And you'll see the difference on this attack. You can already see that there's a big difference in base layout. Before, on the initial entry, you pretty much had two multi-target Infernos on the initial entry. But with that heal spell being able to heal through them, Bowler's Rip right through those ITs. This one's completely different. If you guys look at the ITs on this base, they're on the complete other side of the base. He's also bringing Wall Breakers. And on this one, he doesn't have, Hives is not bringing any healers. So a completely different attack and very, very unique. And you'd probably look at this base. I'm so surprised this base even screened Bow Witch, but after seeing it, completely levels this base. And just look at when the replay ends. It ends in a minute and 50 seconds. It really goes to show you how strong this attack is. And again, it's working on all different types of bases. So what he's gonna be doing here is he's gonna be dropping down a golem right here. And again, the idea behind this is they're gonna trim all of this stuff over here on these flanks. They're gonna get rid of all this. Same thing on this side. Golem is gonna target that mortar. And ideally, they would take out all of this stuff, all this trash. And just like we saw on Zongo's hit, he is gonna drop Wall Breakers to pop that wall. Jump spell right here. And he's gonna have another jump spell right here to lead everything into the back end. And of course, this is pretty much a runway for his kill squad, where he's gonna have two rages, a heal, and he's gonna have a poison, obviously, for the enemy CC. And he's going to have a skeleton spell. Wait till you guys see how he uses that. So without further ado, we'll go ahead and hit play so you guys can watch it live again. Seeing this base, I would have never thought that you would use something like Bow Witch on a base layout like this. So here goes the golems. And you'll see that they're not going to be kind of in the core. That's pretty much going to be where the heroes are going to be headed. And he's bringing a couple skeletons with the heroes, using those skeletons to his advantage to distract, as he doesn't have any high, he doesn't have any high hit point troops other than the heroes really going into the core of this base. So this is pretty much all flanks, taking out all the point defenses and the splash defenses from over the wall. Look at his flanks, guys. Look at the spells. Drop that at heal spell. Did pop king ability. Still is saving queen's ability. Like I said, it's all about saving the queen ability. And a lot of people will often use queen walk bitch on these attacks when there's a hound CC. But we've seen it time and time and time again where you can go ahead and send in that queen, whether there's a hound or not. At this point, it doesn't even really matter what's going to be coming out of the CC. What really matters on these attacks is getting the value from your flanks. If your flanks die on these attacks, the attack is pretty much rip. But as you can see, dropping down those golems to tank not only for the bowlers, but for the witches going down each side. Check this out, guys. Still has that golem, and still has about 20 HP before he even pops. And you'll see he did save his queen ability for the very, very end to take out both of those single shot Inferno towers. And you'll see this is clearly going to wrap up in a three star. Very, very nice attack from Hives. Let's check out the next example. All right, guys, so here's the next base that we're going to be taking a look at. This is going to be coming from the Forbidden and One Hive Genesis War. And again, as you guys see, similar to the last attack where you see the two Inferno Towers on the back end, and you can clearly see just over the wall, you can see where that jump spell is going to go. It's going to lead to both Expos, both Wizard Towers, getting rid of that splash damage.
And you'll see right here on the back end where he's going to go ahead and drop down his second jump spell right there over the expo underneath the queen platform. A rage in there with the queen ability will easily be able to take out those. Even got a mortar that you can bounce. Anytime that you can do a bowler trade for a mortar, definitely worth it, especially on doing something like a bow witch attack. And you'll see on this one, he's got six witches, even has a giant skeleton. Wait till you guys see how he uses the giant skeleton. Six witches, 23 bowlers. That means he's going to be having a max golem that's gonna go ahead and come out of the clan castle. So go ahead and hit play. Here's the bowler bounce right here. This is the trade that I'm talking about. Anytime you guys can grab a free mortar with a bowler, go ahead and do it when doing this attack strategy. So we got three witches, three bowlers. Up at 12, three witches and three bowlers over here at 3. Goes and drops down his own golem and his max golem coming out of the clan castle. So jump spell right over the two wizard towers, eliminating that splash damage nice and early. Here goes the rage. And again, like we said in the last attack, hound or not does not matter for this attack. We have TTD Black sending in his queen, especially with the queen under rage. You can definitely see that hound is going to pop very, very fast with a queen under rage. Goes ahead and lets the troops beat through the wall when the heal spell was healing them up, saving that second jump spell to lead all the troops to the very, very backside of this base. And even though we know that the giant skeleton is going away, whether he had this giant skeleton on the back end or not, this base is going to be wrecked either way. You'll see that giant skeleton got one Tesla, so not a whole bunch. Not sure why he didn't drop it right in the center, to be honest. But again, whether giant skeleton was in this attack or not, this base was completely wrecked. And as you can see, still has queen ability. Look at the flanks. Like I said, it's all about the flanks in this attack, you guys. And TTD Black completely wrecking this base, swagging that ability, and even 10v10 six pack this war. So go ahead and check out how he broke down the second base. All right, guys, here it is. You'll see that other base we looked at was more rectangular, if you will. It was a much longer base. This base is pretty much a straight up square. But again, look at the back end ITs. And this one, these two are on single shot. One thing I did not mention, the reason why this attack strategy is so strong right now compared to before, is the Infernal Towers, whether they're on single target or multi-target, does not matter. One thing to keep in mind, if it's single target, it's only going to target one bowler. If it's multi-target, you can go ahead and heal right through them. So again, very, very strong attack, and we're going to go ahead and see exactly how TTD Black breaks down this base. You can pretty much see at this point, this is our fourth and final replay, how the flanks are going to work, how they can go ahead and take all those defenses off just from over the wall. And again, you have your main kill squad push running up, setting up the flanks, setting up a nice runway for your kill squad, two jumps to lead to the backside. So he go ahead and drops down his first jump over that archer tower, and he's already going to be eliminating two wizard towers on the entry. Going to be getting really, really good value. This was a damage CC where he goes ahead and drops down a poison and a rage to push everything in. And you'll see those flanks still going nice and strong on each side. Look at the bowlers, the value he's getting from this heal spell, healing all them up, jump spell leading everything to the very back end of this base where you have those two single shot ITs. You even have a couple bomb towers, a couple Teslas, but under rage, and again, it's all about that queen ability, saving it to the very, very end. And you'll see right here, and this replay was about a sub 2 minute raid, pretty much completely wipes the floor with this base. And you'll see right here, he still has one witch on that flank, still going strong. Over here on the left side, does still have a few more witches. And look at all those skellies piling up, trimming all of that trash. And you'll see on this attack, he also brought a CC golem. And again, these are not super light bases. These are pretty heavy Town Hall 10 bases. But I mean, that's pretty much going to do it for this Bow Witch attack guide post update. Hopefully you guys all enjoyed it.
This is Riggs from Clashing FFS, and I'll see you in the very next video.